Well, it is great seeing that many people out there. They're all excited about it. I hope the weather stays dry. It looks like it might rain, but obviously we're hoping for the best. I'm joined now here in the pod by a number one selling artist, albeit with the help from Gareth Gates and Comic Relief. It's Sanjeev Bhaskar. Sanjeev, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
Good to have you here. Are you enjoying the music? Are you enjoying the atmosphere so far?
It's incredible. I mean, it is. I mean, people can see the crowds, and you've had shots of the crowds. It is like a kind of small Indian do.
Yeah.
So it doesn't really faze me that much.
Not a lot of people by your standards then?
No, it's average.
You know what I'm finding weird is, even though we know there are a couple of hundred thousand people there, it doesn't sort of look like that many, does it? It's a weird thing to try and compute it.
Well, the thing is, it's strange with numbers, isn't it? People kind of like, they just become numbers after 100,000, 200,000, just become numbers. If anyone who's trying to get into this place will realise how many people, not just a view of that, that's amazing.
Did you catch the Gay Pride Mark outside earlier, the Gay Pride March?
I was part of it for about 25 yards, actually, because I wasn't quite sure which side of the road I was supposed to be on. And somebody stole my hot pants.
Weren't sure which way to turn when you go.
No, not really. Yeah. It was a junction.
How many of these can we do? He pulled into the wrong station at Paddington, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be great. Anyone in particular you're looking forward to? I mean, you're what? You're in your early 50s now. So I imagine Pink Floyd being back together, that would be exciting for you.
That's very exciting, actually, yes. And Pink...
Pink Floyd.
Floyd, yes. He's the guy who used to do the cooking, didn't he?
Yeah.
No, obviously, U2 and Paul McCartney. I mean, that's going to be astounding. But everyone who's kind of joined in, it's just interesting seeing people milling about as well.
Yeah, it is strange. Well, you know, everyone, I mean, I know I've been reading the papers, people talking about there may well be backstage demands and different kind of ego clashes. I haven't seen any of that. I haven't experienced any of that. So everyone really seems to be mucking in together, which is what you would hope for, of course.
Well, except for me.
Yeah, and what have you been asking?
Well, I asked for some paneer. Good Indian cheese, because I think that's essential to any kind of message.
What's the matter? They can't get paneer.
That's good. What's the matter?
We're doing some Indian takeaway-based gag. Well, it's takeaway for me. For you, it's not, obviously.
No, for me, it's eating.
I can't wait for it to start. It really is. You can feel the atmosphere kind of like getting to that boiling point now, I think, can't you, out there?
Yeah, I mean, and also on the way in as well. I mean, just the sense of expectation, also a sense of occasion. I mean, you know, we're lucky enough to be been around for 85.
Yeah.
And you never think there's going to be another thing like that in your lifetime. And I think this is going to be one of those things that in the next day, week, month, and years to come, people will kind of go, gosh, I was there.
Where were you?
I was watching it.
Where were you for Live Aid itself?
I was at my parents' house in the back garden. I had to mow the lawn. It was a very hot day. And my dad, I hadn't mowed the lawn for ages. And my dad said, you have to cut the grass. And I said, wait, Live Aid's on. He said, Live Aid will be on all day.
Well, you know what? We want you to cut a bit of grass out here just to keep that continuity going on. Sanjeev, it's lovely to see you. I'm sure we'll be talking to you later on during the day.
Yeah.
But if you want to get back out and enjoy the concert, and I'll see you out there a bit later on. Fern, as you know, is backstage. She's going out to meet some of the crowd. She's also backstage chatting to some of the performers we have. Fern, are you there? And can you smell the fear yet?
I can smell the excitement, Jonathan. This is absolutely amazing, right? You know that U2 and Paul McCartney will be opening with Sergeant Pepper? They're at the marching band, getting ready. The show is almost about to start, and they're just preparing, tuning up their trombones and all that malarkey. Here I am in Radio City again. I've seen many a celeb walking up and down. I've seen U2 walk past again. I just saw Travis. I saw Dougie and Fran up here somewhere as well. We've got Ulrika Johnson just over there, milling about, networking, that sort of thing. And I can still see Jonathan Ross in his little pod up there. There's Ronan. Hello, Ronan, how are you?
How are you doing?
We're on BBC One. How are you doing? He's on the phone, bless him. Are you having a great day?
I'm having a great day. What a buzz. I mean, just to be part of it, it's very exciting. Very
it's amazing,
cool.
Isn't it? Really, can you describe the atmosphere for us right now?
Kofi Annan just came in the back there and walked up to Bono. I mean, where would you get it, you know? It's two amazing. Of them are chatting in the corner. I mean, it's unbelievable.
Is it just about the music for you today?
It's about the music. It's about making a difference, and that's what it's about. It's about the audience making a difference, and hopefully we can help, you know.
Have a brilliant day. Thank you very much, Ronan. Cheers. Cheers. Thanks. Back to you, Jonathan.
Thank you, Fern. It really is. It's all kind of like getting going now. We're just a few brief minutes away. I've got Joe Wiley here. Joe, you've been down in that kind of like holding pen area there.
Yeah, it's the first time I've come out and seen here. And
look at the crowd. You really can
stunning.
See.
Absolutely stunning. I was here yesterday for the rehearsals, came down, and I left at about 9:30 at night. There were people queuing at the front, standing up. I don't know why they were standing up, why they didn't just sit there. But from 9:00 last night...
They didn't want to sit down because it was damp, I believe. They wanted to keep their trousers dry.
No, it was okay. And Madonna was doing the rehearsals yesterday.
And how were her rehearsals?
Really good.
I heard she was blowing people away. Everyone said it was incredible.
Yeah, it was like a little mini gig. She was kind of relating to the audience and everything. But she's looking and sounding better than I've ever heard of.
You didn't catch Macca rehearsing with you too yet, did you? Have you heard that?
No, I haven't yet, no. Did you?
No, and that's a real... I think that's going to be a real moment to kick off with
absolutely.
That. It's really going to be quite special. So make sure you don't go anywhere for at least the next half hour so. We're about a minute away, or 2 minutes away from it starting off. What are the highlights for you, do you think? What will they be today? What are you looking forward to most?
I'm looking forward to seeing some of the smaller bands taken to the stage and kind of seizing the moment and just kind of, bands like The Killers and Razorlight, but then also it's big bands like U2.
Because there were people at Live Aid, of course, who we maybe weren't that familiar with before, and they appeared there, and everyone were knocked out by, like, Tracy Chapman, people like that.
The two bands I just mentioned.
The Killers are going to be great, I think.
Absolutely, yeah.
And you're schmoozing downstairs with people, looking after them, making sure they're comfortable.
I'm doing my bit. I'm working hard, you know. It's a tough job. Someone's got to do it.
Are these boots official requirement for today down there? Because they're going to be good if it does get muddy, are they? You're going to down
to your... I was at Glastonbury last week. I couldn't wear them at all, so I had to wear them tonight.
Well, really? You should be wearing them now. There's an orthopedic quality to them, frankly, that I find a little bit worrying.
Well, maybe I need them, you know?
Is one slightly longer than the other? All right, okay. Well, we're going to catch up with you later, of course.
Who are you looking forward to seeing?
I've got to do a link now, so I'll tell you that in a minute.
Okay.
Of course, today's events are very much in the spirit of that legendary day 20 years ago. I don't think I'm ever going to forget Live Aid today, and those who were there 20 years ago have never forgotten Live Aid, okay? It's going to be a memory to match that, I'm sure. It was just 20 years ago today, and who knows, in 20 years' time, we might be looking at this with the same degree of kind of like nostalgia, and it's going to be as powerful a memory. Yeah, well, hopefully.
I hope so.
If you keep wearing those shoes, you probably will. You'll be in a chair, love.
As long as you push me around, I don't care.
It really is close now.
Do kind of get that sense of history, don't you, today?
Yeah.
All the bands there. Because, you kind of met these people before, Elton and Bono, and you see them, they're always kind of in control. But today, you can see they're actually sweating.
Yeah, I know.
Really quite nervous.
You two earlier on, they did seem genuinely quite...
No, I've never seen them so subdued in my life. And yeah. I was like, God, am I doing this wrong? But no, they're genuinely nervous.
It's quite a nice thing to see them put back in their place.
Absolutely, yeah.
No. I'm so looking forward to it. But you're a veteran of these kind of big OBs, though, and these big events like this, aren't you?
Yeah, I know, but they are normally a lot grubbier, it's just a lot more scuzzy. Yeah. But, I don't know, just seeing the people here today, and when you were making your journey here, and seeing people in buses, and cheering in the streets, it's just incredible.
Curiously, they weren't cheering when I went by.
Were they not? was there any booing or anything like that?
Nothing like that at all. It really is. You know, I don't think we impress on people just how momentous this feels to be here. I'm hoping at home you're picking up on some of that as well. Bear in mind, once again, there are concerts going on all over the world today, all of them, and they're all kicking off at roughly the same local time. They're all going off about the same time, all for one reason, of course, to focus attention on the G8 summit. And what a remarkable achievement by Sir Bob and all those around.
Oh, no, incredibly, absolutely incredible. I mean, Chris Martin's always been very vocal in his support as well. As a Coldplay, really looking forward to seeing them. I think they're doing Fix You, which is the best thing on the album they've just brought out. That's going to be a phenomenal moment when they do that.
Yeah, I mean, but just about everyone who's here today, you know, I think are here for the right reasons, of course. Occasionally you get sniping in the press and people saying people are here to try and sell albums.
People are talking about ego, and that's absolutely not the issue. If you could see what it's like backstage, the little porter cabins where you used to have your lessons at school, kind of thing. And all, you know, they've just got a little name outside, you too, Madonna.
Joe, let me draw your attention to what we're seeing on the screens right now.
Wow.
Look at the scope of that crowd there. That really is.
Wow.
That's that. Okay. We're going to kick off the show in a minute. Am I doing the big link now? Are we going
to
start it now?
Don't you hope so?
Okay. It's 2:00 in London on July the 2nd, 2005. Oh, we're going to go into something else. I'm sorry. That's the big link for the show. We're not quite ready just yet. Let's have a look. Let's remind ourselves. I was talking about this earlier. Let's remind ourselves about the journey from Live Aid to the present day Live Aid. It's been 20 years. Here's the experience.
Yeah! It's 2 o'clock in London on July the 2nd, 2005. Hyde Park welcomes the world to Live 8. Live from the Tiergarten in Berlin. From the Circus Maximus in Rome. From the Chateau de Versailles in Paris. From Mary Fitzgerald Square in Johannesburg. And from Makuhari Messe, Tokyo. And also from the Art Museum in Philadelphia. This is Live 8, the greatest rock show in the history of the world.